Hi, this is Dr. Jerome Fryer, talking primarily to the patients that have back or leg pain associated with extended walking. Pain when walking a specific distance, for example. Stuart McGill, I'm just going through Stuart McGill's back mechanic book. And if you have pain when walking a specific distance, it's kind of classic, a classic presentation for lumbar spinal stenosis. Lumbar spinal stenosis often presents in the clinic here for me when a patient explains to me that they can walk like, you know, 200 meters and they have to sit down, or they can only walk so long in the mall and then they have to sit down. Well, stenosis is a word that means narrowing. So anything that's kind of narrowed when nerves are traveling through it is going to be susceptible to compression because of the encroaching sort of walls around it. And what we mean by that, here's the spinal canal. And you can see that the spinal canal is, put the smiley face upside right. So you can see also, I had to put my Italian leather jacket on. I don't even have a name for this guy. So if you guys, you know, want to offer a name, but I think it's better on him than me right now. But anyways, back to this. The canal is, you can see how wide it is there. This is a normal specimen, degenerative. This is a normal specimen without any degeneration. Good disc height, about 10 mils on the back, 12 on the front. Good spacing, the facet joints, and it's quite open. This is a stenosis model. You can see the facet joints are arthritic. Right? See how much more they're arthritic? And the canal is quite narrowed, respectively. And, you know, this is because primarily the disc is bulging back, and also the ligamentum flavum is buckling and kind of folding onto itself, kind of like a soft tire. You know, if you can kind of tell when you have a low tire because it kind of bulges out a little bit. It's kind of what the ligamentum flavum does, very similarly. But one of the things that I explain to patients is that, you know, well, what they explain to me is that their symptoms, you know, present in their legs after a certain period of time, and then they have to sit down. And what happens is when you walk and a disc that's degenerated can't really support the weight very well, the hydraulics have been disrupted, so it kind of, it's like a tire, it deflates quicker, and that will narrow the spinal canal, and they have to sit to relieve the symptoms. So you can see how there's a certain amount of friction here with this pen, and when they walk, everything compresses down and it's even harder to pull out, right? So it's not even a word. So, but then they have to sit to create space in that spinal canal. And you can see when they sit, it opens up the spinal canal. So the best series of exercises are ones that induce flexion, but with the mindset that you have to think about exercises that increase that disc height. So any type of flexion exercises, like on your stomach, for example, like on a ball, an exercise ball, to create flexion but not compressing the disc as much. Also, if you're on your back, you can bring your knees up to your chest within, you know, a significant, you don't want to crank it too much because you're compressing the disc. And you know, there's that decompression chair care exercise that you can kind of, you know, push down with your arms and lean back. Another wonderful one is you can press on your front of your thighs like this and press down. Those are all really good exercises. Another one is child's pose. I don't know if you, those people that do yoga, child's pose is, you know, lying on your stomach and you create a little bit of flexion. So any of those exercises will likely be helpful if you have a condition called lumbar spinal stenosis. I hope that was helpful.